Here's a quick derivation for the surface area of a surface of revolution that is revolved around the x-axis. And so the sort of concept is you're going to slice this surface into little ribbons. This is called physical integration, where you view something as being made of a bunch of tiny contributions, and then the integral just adds all those up. Right here, I'm going to mark a little line segment and say that's a ds, so a tiny chunk of arc length. And I'm going to pop that out so we can get a closer look. And I had a curve f of x. And then I had a ds superimposed on it. And that's the thickness of the ribbon. So there's my ds. And then I can break ds into x and y components. There's a dx and a dy. And I can say that ds is the square root of dx squared plus dy squared. So we can factor a dx squared out of the interior. And I get a 1 plus dy dx squared dx. So pulling a dx squared out of the square root gives you just a dx. And dy dx is just the first derivative of the function that we're looking at. So I have f prime of x squared dx. All right, so that's my little ds. And then I'm going to cut and unroll the ribbon. And it has a thickness of ds. And then we have to figure out how to express its length. And the area of the ribbon is what I would call dA, a contribution to the total area of this function. So the length of the ribbon, well, that's just the circumference of it when it was rolled up. So if I'm at a location x right here, then the height of the function there, f of x, is the radius of that ribbon. So the circumference is going to be 2 pi times the radius. And I arrive at an expression for the infinitesimal contribution to area. If I plug in then what I worked out for s, or ds I mean, I get f of x square root 1 plus f prime of x squared dx. And then finally I have an expression for the surface area for a curve that's revolved around the x-axis. The total area is going to be the sum of all the area contributions. And I'm going to go all the way from the starting value of x to the finishing value of x.